The sibling rivalry between the two chambers of parliament is going a notch higher tonight, with the National Assembly asking the Senate to stop summoning cabinet secretaries handling dockets whose functions are not devolved. Speaker of the National Assembly, Justice Muturi, insists the Senate was violating the constitution that outlines functions of each house in the bicameral parliament. Francis Kashuri reports.
The second National Assembly leadership retreat in Mombasa, and nearly 9 years after the country transited into a new constitutional order, the two chambers of parliament are embroiled in a vicious supremacy contest, each claiming control over the other. National Assembly top brass claiming the Senate was punching above its weight.
If you want to make our Senate upper house, it is very simple. Either call for a referendum or wait for if there will be any referendum and sneak your ideas through. But do not make our Senate upper house through the back door.
The two chambers have been squabbling over their respective legislative mandate, with the question of who among them is the upper house lingering.
It's only the National Assembly which can pass any law on its own. The Senate can never pass even those ones where they have jurisdiction. Those ones to protect the interests of the counties. They must bring them to the people's representatives.
Even where we are dealing with the joint sitting of the houses, the Constitution says the Speaker of the National Assembly shall preside and assisted by the Speaker of the Senate.
The jurisdiction row between the two houses is manifest whenever accountability issues arise in any of the dockets in the national government.
The only aspect which is devolved is ECD. So the Minister for Education can only appear in the Senate in as far as ECD matters are concerned.
Cabinet secretaries and accounting officers in ministries, all other government agencies, often caught up in the rivalry between the two chambers.
It is very frustrating to receive four letters on one day. You are supposed to go before four committees one day. Two committees in the National Assembly, two committees in the Senate. And I keep asking myself the question, who said that someone will die if you sat together, the two committees?
Some committees in Parliament have been accused of using their oversight role for rent-seeking. The sugar probe and the Ruaraka land compensation saga ranking top in allegations of corruption.
Though the constitution is explicit on the functions and responsibilities of each house in the bicameral parliament introduced by the 2010 Supreme Law, the sibling rivalry between the two chambers of parliament, the National Assembly and the Senate, persists. The onus is on the two speakers to enforce these laws candidly so that each house is able to conduct its functions of legislation, representation and oversight. Francis Gashuri, Citizen TV, Mombasa County.